Well, by anyone's standard, 2020 has not been the year we thought it would be.
True statement there. For Governor Gary Herbert, COVID-19 has turned his final months in office from glory days to crisis management. New specialist Dave McCann speaking with the governor under the lights. He joins us now live from Utah County. Hi, Dave.
Hey, Mike. What a year it's been. It's only halfway through. I sat down with the governor 6 feet apart in a very familiar place to discuss these very unfamiliar times.
Can I take off my mask?
Yeah, you can take that off. Do you remember where you were the first time you heard the word coronavirus?
Oh, gee, I think I probably saw it on television. Probably around February. Hadn't come to Utah yet.
In your wildest dreams, could you imagine what it was about to do to us?
No, the answer is absolutely no. Think about where we were in January. We had the best economy in America, an all-time record low unemployment at 2.3%. Things looked just so rosy and so wonderful. By the end of March, we're in a declared pandemic, and the economy just dropped off the side of the cliff. On top of that, right in the middle of this, we're getting the pandemic, we have an earthquake.
Well, then in the middle of that, you have George Floyd dies in Minneapolis, and then you've got violent protests in your street.
We end up having protesters, the pandemic, economic freefall. You know, we've had fires. 2020 is a year that I was gonna love.
This was gonna be your victory lap.
Well, at least my last dash to the finish line.
With so much discord and unrest in the country, how do we get through all of this stronger and better?
Well, we certainly need to find ways to unite. We have a hard time communicating. We sometimes talk past each other rather than we should listen more. People that feel like they've been discriminated against are sincere. Why are they feeling that way? I remember when President Obama was elected, who I think I consider a friend. We disagree on policy in a number of areas, but I think he's a good man. And even though I did not support his election, I thought, what a great day for America. We finally have elected an African American to the highest office in the land.
Do you think COVID's affected the GOP primary?
I think it's affected from the standpoint of people having to campaign differently.
Do you think your lieutenant governor can hang on to his, 10,000 vote lead through the weekend and into next week?
Well, I'm a follower of Yogi Berra, one of the great philosophers. I remember Yogi Berra from New York Yankees, and he said, I hate to make predictions, particularly about the future. We'll have to wait for the votes to come in and see what happens.
You and I have spent the last three July 3rds right here at Lavelle Edwards Stadium rehearsing for Stadium of Fire. Show's canceled, and tonight it's just you and me. This is weird.
It is weird. I've been here now for over 30 years in a row.
Where do you go for your patriotism?
When I was 5 years of age, my mother was single at the time, and I was living with my grandmother. But she had a record that had Kate Smith singing God Bless America and also the Star Spangled Banner. I loved those songs. I was five. I used to go and play it on this phonograph in my grandma's house. And I don't know, there was something that stirred inside me all the time when I'd hear those songs be sung.
Do you think on September 3rd, there will be a kickoff between BYU and Utah at Rice-Eccles Stadium under these circumstances?
Well, I have tickets, if that means anything. It's an iffy thing. As I've said before, we have a great plan in place that will, in fact, get us through this pandemic and help us to reopen the economy. As I said in the very beginning, this plan will only work if all of us take on our own individual responsibility to do our part. Social distancing, which we're doing here, and wearing of the mask.
Right.
But it's up to us, the individual.
And if we want to see that football game, it will take 2 months of mask wearing?
That's right. It will certainly help. And we were able to then do some better contact tracing. If we will all follow these guidelines, we can have a sports season.
Just up the road from this football stadium, you played football at Orem High. Quarterback, 1964.
Great year.
You still have it?
Well, I don't know if I've got all of it, but I got some of it.
Let's find out.
Okay.
Quite a night at the stadium. After our broadcast ends, we invite you to go to the KSL-TV Facebook page and KSLTV.com, and we'll show you how we put the governor to the test. I think you'll be impressed. He is 73 years old,
And it was a lot of fun to watch him throw the football around. Also tonight, the governor and the first lady celebrating their 50th wedding anniversary. We send them a heartfelt congratulations. In Provo, I'm Dave McCann. Mike, have a great 4th of July.
Dave, I'm sure he can still throw. My question is, can you catch?
I caught a few.
Okay, good.
Go to Facebook and you'll see it.
I'll be watching. All right. Have a good weekend, Dave. Thanks.